Welcome to Open Heaven's Devotional Commentary, a guide to a close fellowship with God with Salami Energy Harina, your host. We are glad to have you today.
Hello, good morning. Thank you for joining us today again. Open Heavens is written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor E.A. Adeboye, General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And this commentary is intended to bring insight to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today's date is Saturday, the 15th day of May 2021. And our topic for today is, You Must Live and Cleave. Let us pray. Our gracious God, our Father in heaven, we bless your name. Thank you for your Word that enriches us daily. We are glad to be before you one more time. Do in our lives that which you alone knows how to do best. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. You are welcome back. Our memory verse for today is from the book of Matthew chapter 19 verse 5. Matthew 19 verse 5 reads, For this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh. Matthew 19 verse 5. Our Bible reading for today is from the book of Ephesians chapter 5 verse 25 to 31. Ephesians 5 25 to 31 reads, Husband, love your wives even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word, that he might present it to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it, even as the Lord the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall be one flesh. God bless his word in Jesus' name. Amen. Our Father in the Lord says in today's devotional that marriage is a good thing when God is in it. The Bible says in Proverbs 18 verse 22, Whoso findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtaineth favor of the Lord. The scripture dismisses the wrong notion that marriage is an entanglement or a necessary evil. Our memory verse today reveals that the man must leave his parents and cleave to his wife. However, it takes love, the God type of love, for a man to totally leave his parents and cleave to his wife. For marriage to work, the man must strictly adhere to this twin command, leaving his parents and cleaving to his wife. This love we are talking about today is unconditional. It is not predicated on whether the woman is good or bad. The moment you say, I do, you are under obligation to love your wife as yourself, according to our Bible reading of today, which says in part, Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for it. Ephesians 5 verse 25. 1 Corinthians 7 verse 32 to 33 reads, But I would have you without carefulness. He that is unmarried careth for the things that belong to the Lord, how he may please the Lord. But he that is married careth for the things that are of the world, how he may please his wife. The truth in the above passage is that a man is under obligation to cater for the joy and well-being of his wife. Some so-called Christians are so careless about their marriage that they neglect the divine mandate of caring for the family, leaving the wife and children disillusioned about the faith. To love is to care, and to care encompasses the provision of basic amenities for the home. The Bible says in James chapter 2 verse 18, Yea, a man may say, Thou hast faith, and I have works. Show me thy faith without thy works, and I will show thee my faith by my works. In the same way, men must show their love in practical terms to such an extent that there will be no doubt that they love their wives. Note that the Bible didn't say abandon your family and friends, but you are to leave them and cleave to your wife in a lifelong union built on the sure foundation of the Word of God. God bless his word to us today in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Today's topic is a very important and sensitive one. Sensitive in the sense that families are a very special unit. After the individual, the family is where the society is built. And families start from marriages. When a marriage has gone wrong, it produces offsprings with wrong foundations. And those offsprings in turn become a menace in the society. And when we have a society filled with such offsprings, it becomes a cause for concern. Our Father in the Lord talks about some people who have the wrong notion that marriage is an entanglement or a necessary evil. The Bible tells us that finding a wife is a good thing and it is obtaining favor from the Lord. If the experience of any man is different from this, then he needs to look closer. God's original plan is for it to be blissful. Our Father in the Lord tells us today that for a marriage to work, a man has to leave his parents and cleave to his wife. In other words, the two of them which used to be separate now become one, bounded together by God's kind of love. And we learn today that this love is unconditional. He also mentioned something very important today. He says that this kind of love is not dependent on whether the woman is good or not. So this is selfless. This love is an obligation. The same way Christ loves the church, we are expected to love too. The Bible says that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Our love must be selfless and not dependent on whether the individual even deserves it or not. Remember, it is an obligation, a duty that you owe to God and to the individual. Our Father in the Lord tells us also today that the man is under the obligation to cater for the joy and well-being of his wife. This is also very important. It is not expected that anyone be careless in his responsibility to provide, be it financially, materially, or otherwise. It could even be emotionally. 1 Timothy 5 verse 8 tells us that, "But if any provide not for his own, and specially for those of his own house, he had denied the faith and is worse than an infidel." A proof that you truly belong to this household of faith is that you are responsible to provide. Our Father in the Lord tells us also that some Christians are so careless about their marriage that they neglect the divine mandate of caring for the family. It is not ideal being present in all church services or maybe even flying around the world doing ministry, the whole world feeling your impact, while you are absent from your first assignment, your family. Our Father in the Lord also tells us today that men must show their love in practical terms to such an extent that is undeniable. In other words, sometimes care to the physical needs of your wife. It is not unspiritual to surprise her, take her out, and make her feel loved. A successful ministry starts from the home. When you do this, you'd be amazed to see God's work prosper even more in your hands. In 1 Peter chapter 3 verse 7, the scripture tells us there that prayers can be hindered if men do not dwell with their wives according to knowledge. That's very powerful. In other words, prayers can receive accelerated attention and answers when a husband dwells with his wife according to knowledge. May God give us understanding in Jesus' name. Praise God. But while it looks like today's focus is more on the man, when we go further down in our Bible reading today, in Ephesians chapter 5 verse 33, it tells us that the wife also has the duty to reverence her husband, so this should be balanced. And we trust God that our homes will be models. They will be peaceful and bring glory to God in the name of Jesus. We'd bow our heads now and pray. We'd say, "Father, please give me the grace to love my spouse unconditionally in the name of Jesus. The kind of love that does not have conditions attached to it. The type that has no requirements. Help me, Lord, to have your own kind of love for my spouse." And if you are not married yet, pray that same prayer that God will build in you this kind of love even before time, that he would make the journey easy for you. When the time comes to leave and to cleave, you would find joy, ease, and fulfillment in it. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Our Father in heaven, we give you praise. Thank you for this word today. We are grateful for your desire to see us flourish even in our marriages. We ask that your hand would come and rest upon any marriage that is going through a storm right now in the name of Jesus. We ask that you speak peace, be still to it. Let all storms be calm. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. In our Bible in 1 year reading plan for today, we read from the book of Mark chapter 1, chapter 2 and chapter 3. Praise the Lord. Thank you for joining us today. We are glad you came around. If you'd love to speak to someone or to receive updates like this daily, please send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 80 986 11226. Do well also to share this with someone and bless them today. Have a great and fulfilling heaven on earth marriage in the name of Jesus. Amen. Bye for now.
I believe you enjoyed today's devotional. We'd love to hear from you. Kindly leave a comment. You can connect with us on any of our social media handles attached. God bless you. Have a great day and see you tomorrow.